John Stanton. Everybody calls me Jack. I'm a writer with a local writers group called Night Writers, the Maple Grove Night Writers. Our music today, Laura, Masika, Jed Noss, they're both also talented writers. The Night Writers is a writing critique group that traces its roots back almost 20 years across the Twin Cities. We have writers that are just starting, writers that are commercially published under contract, fiction, nonfiction, poetry, every genre you can think of. We are also managing a small publishing house, too, now. So this summer, we're expanding. We're looking to spin off a sister group. So we've got people approaching us interested in learning how to get into the craft. There's more information on our website, www.nightwritersbooks.com. We have a bookmark with our website on it there. Thanks to our musicians. Thanks to Lori, the Art Center people, who it's been a great collaboration with our writing group, their support, bringing in national exhibits as well as us local artists. So, big sloppy with kisses. One of the things I write in addition to novels is I like to do poetry, and this is a piece of short spoken word that I wrote a little while ago, and this is based on a true story. And my blues man, Judd, will back me up with a little 12-bar style on this. But this is a true story about third grade. You remember when you were a kid at third grade? To a third grader, the grass is greener, the sun is sunnier, the imagination is clear and sharp. But my most vivid third grade memory isn't of holding a little girl's hand in the playground or the wonders of science class. Now, the thing I remember from third grade the most, Gordon Spoonwell kicked my ass. I don't know why he decided to kick my ass, but every kid in third grade got beat up by Gordon Spoonwell at least once. Beating people up was his gig. It's how he rolled. It was his thing. He was the biggest kid in third grade for 3 years running. When the day for my beatdown came, he caught me after school at the edge of the playground, but I was ready. You see, I'd been watching Bruce Lee play Kato on the Green Hornet TV show. Well, you can imagine that didn't help at all. Gordon Spoonwell didn't have to kick my ass. He just threw me on the ground so hard, the ground kicked my ass for him. My head clonked on the hard, packed dirt, making a sound like it was made from hollow wood. My body felt like a squirrel that got hit by a car. My vision blurred as I sniffed back tears. Now, in all his years of beating people up, Gordon Spoonwell never had a beatdown go that easy. Normally, he'd have to throw some punches or something, but he now stood over my incapacitated body, having expended no effort whatsoever, and it confused him. He leaned over to see if I was dead. In that moment, I summoned all my strength, pain, and fear, and I hit Gordon Spoonwell right in the head with my Star Trek lunchbox. Now, back in those days, children's lunchboxes were made from the same metal that folding metal chairs are made out of. And it made an awesome metallic bang. I hit him in the head next to the lump where his mom had whacked him with a heavy wooden cooking spoon. Next to the dent where his dad had popped him with a 3/4-inch opened-end wrench. Now, there's no way you're going to hurt Gordon Spoonwell by hitting him in the head with a metal Star Trek lunchbox. But he doesn't get hit that often, except for his mom and his dad and his older brother and his other older brother and his drunken Uncle Pete and his older cousin Hilda, maybe a few other people. But generally, people didn't hit Gordon Spoonwell, and he had to stand there thinking about it. He stared into the distance, wondering why it didn't hurt to get hit in the head with a metal Star Trek lunchbox. He stood there thinking about getting hit in general, and that's when I did it. I made my escape. I dashed from the playground, vaulted the fence, flew down alleys, cut through backyards. I ran like a striped-ass ape. And nobody runs away from Gordon Spoonwell. We all knew that you only get it worse if you make him wait. So I knew that one day he would kill me. But that night, a miracle happened. That night, a divine miracle from God happened, and the next day there was a new kid in school. There was a new kid in school, and his name was Gaylord. New kids in school automatically got moved to the front of Gordon Spoonwell's beatdown lineup, and boys named Gaylord got the double express bonus treatment. Needless to say, Gordon Spoonwell forgot all about beating me up, forgot my name if he even ever knew it. But as the years and decades passed, I'll always remember the day Gordon Spoonwell kicked my ass. Thank you.